Hey everybody, what's up? Today I have a video showing you my paper magic spell table gameplay setup. So here's my setup. It's pretty simple. I will show you the key components of kind of what you're gonna need if you are looking to play some paper magic over Spelltable. Here is sort of my gameplay area. Having a webcam is obviously critical. I have my webcam set up here on this really handy arm. It just sort of screws in and I can adjust it, make it taller or shorter or whatever. It's very handy. I think there are arms like this with just a stand, and I've also seen arms that have like a clamp that would clamp onto the end of your desk or your table or whatever you're using. Super handy to have, and I just got this one on Amazon. I will post a link to this product in the video description below. As you can see, my webcam is technically pointed upside down from my playmat, but it's a Logitech webcam, and so it comes with the Logitech software that I use to flip my video, but that is not necessary at all. You don't have to have that. You can totally flip your video in Spelltable very easily. Everybody's little screen on Spelltable has this box in the top right corner. You can click it and flip the video. You can flip your video and anyone else's video. So if you need to point your webcam upside down, no problem. Super easy to flip it. You'll obviously need a microphone of some kind. I just have mine here so that I can talk into it when I'm looking at the screen, playing with my friends. I usually have little earbuds plugged into the top of my computer that I listen to. I don't have them plugged in right now, but you need speakers or a headset or something, obviously. And then another really important thing is the lighting. I think this is probably the hardest thing about getting your paper magic setup, is getting the lighting right. So I have this ring light that I use. So if I'm streaming a podcast or arena or something with video on my face, I would have it pointing at me. But when I play EDH, I sort of just point it upwards into the corner of the space that I play in so that the light isn't pointing directly down at my playmat, because When I've done that, it makes the cards way too shiny and too bright, and you just can't even read them. You can't click on them in Spelltable or anything. You can't see them. So I just point it sort of up into the space to light up the area without any direct light. And you don't have to have a specific special light like this. I've heard of people using just a lamp without the lampshade on. It works just fine. It will light up the area and not cast any light that's too harsh right on your cards or anything. So, I think that's pretty much it. It's, like I said, a pretty basic setup. Again, I will post links to the products that I use in the video description below. And if you have any additional questions, oh my gosh, wait, I forgot to show you the most important part. The cat bed. Very critical part of my desk setup. But anyways, if you have any questions, please feel free to ask in the comments below. I hope you can get some good ideas out of this, and hope you get to play a lot of paper magic. Thanks for watching. Have a super great day. Bye! This video brought to you by Cardsphere. Click their link in the description below.